Meet Nathaniel Bacon, who was a Virginia planter who was just as salty as the breakfast meat that bears his name. You need to know that Bacon was not very fond of the Indians who were encroaching on his land from the west, and he was even less fond of William Berkeley, the governor of Virginia, who could not be bothered to do anything about the constant attacks from the Indians on his westernmost citizens. So Bacon was fed up with this, and he gathered about 1,000 poor and angry farmers, most of whom were former indentured servants, marched to Jamestown, killing both friendly and hostile Indians on the way, chased Berkeley from the city, and put Jamestown to the torch. That action inspired other frustrated freedmen and indentured servants to go rioting and plundering, and very soon the colony was in chaos. Now, shortly thereafter, Bacon died of dysentery, probably, and without their leader, the rebellion quickly died out. Now, this rebellion wouldn't be all that important to American history, except that it got the rich folks worried and anxious about all those shiftless and angry poor folks. It got them so fearful, in fact, that they began to look for a better and more reliable source of labor, and so they turned their eyes to Africa. Now, you'll recall that the first ship carrying merchants who hawked flesh instead of goods landed in Jamestown in 1619. And by 1670, which is 6 years before Bacon's rebellion, there were about 2,000 slaves in Virginia, which was about 7% of the population. But by 1750, African slaves made up about half of the population in Virginia. Now, most of the African slaves who reached the shores of America came from the west coast of Africa and were captured not by those crazy white people, but by black African slavers who profited enormously off the deal. The captives were then branded with hot irons, bound with chains, and then herded onto a ship to endure what historians have come to call the Middle Passage across the Atlantic, which was brutal and deadly. And so it's here that laws begin to be established in the South called Black Codes, which made sharp distinctions between what was lawful for white people and what was lawful for black people. According to these codes, black people became chattel, which is another word for property. And maybe most devastating of all, the codes stated that children of slaves would belong to their owners, which is almost unheard of in the history of slavery.